Hello friends, for success in life we need to have a high curiosity quotient. By curiosity what I mean is your ability to seek answers to thousands of questions that are surrounding you, but without expecting any concrete returns. I am Prakash Shesh, and in this series of in and out of the box videos, we are going to seek answers which you should have done long ago. All of us have used piggy banks when we were children, and our children use piggy banks even today. But have you ever realized or have you ever wondered why that device is called a piggy bank? Why not a catty bank or a doggy bank or maybe a tigery bank? Why is that bank not named after any other animal than a pig? The history goes back into the Western society in Britain. People used to buy small piglets in the market, bring them home, and used to feed them on leftovers, because pigs grow just on the basis of leftovers. They do not have to be given any special diet or special food. And they would increase in weight. In about 6 or 8 months' time, the pigs used to become fat enough to be resold to the butcher so that people could slaughter them and then eat ham. So because of this practice, a bank like that was called a piggy bank, because without spending anything, without incurring any substantial expenses, the balances grew as you keep on saving little by little every day. And at the end of the season, or at the end of those 6 or 8 months, you smashed the piggy bank to retrieve the wealth that you had, you know, stored in it. So that's how poor families in England used to do. They would put their meager savings into buying a piglet, raise the pig, that means increase its weight by feeding him actually the leftovers of the family food, and finally when it became fat enough, they would get their returns by selling the fat pig at a neat profit. That is why the bank was called a piggy bank and not named after any other animal.
For more such interesting facts from Prakash Shesh, please like this video and subscribe to our channel.